So we are going to talk a little about Shennong. You know, this is the second book in German and the second book in Danish too. But it's 2.5 years since I wrote this book, so you have to bear over me. What I'm now saying is purely improvised. Shennong. This is a book about what's happening when bad and evil is turning together inside a person and amongst people. So when I was a kid, I lived in a mental hospital. My father was a psychiatrist, and I was allowed to see everything in the mental hospital. There I met a patient called Karl Merck. Not Karl, but Merck. And Merck, he was a killer. I found him quite sympathetic. He gave me a little soft gray kitten, and he even brought food every day to our house. But anyway, he killed someone, and I was only 6 years old, so I was quite confused. How could a nice killer also be evil and good at the same time? This is the thing about this story, Shennong. Bad and evil in the same persons. We're talking about a black lady living on the streets, and this black lady has got a huge and grim secret in her life. That's why she's a black lady. So this lady is being chosen by very, very powerful men in Denmark to be their next offer. And why? Because she was formerly a good friend of them and made terrible things with these guys. So this is the whole chase. And this specific protagonist called Kimmy, the main character of the book, has got a lot of sorrow in her life. So living in this mental hospitals, I mean, you learned a lot of persons, different persons to know. For instance, a woman who looked upon me when I was only 6 years old with that sad and sorrowful eyes I never saw before. She was alone in the Christmas time. We, as doctors and their families, sang along with the patients. And suddenly I saw into her eyes and saw the sorrowness. And I fell in love, you know, with that woman. She was 40 years old, I guess. I was only a kid. But at the same time, she looked at me and chose me as her son in that specific moment. I never forget those eyes. And you know, this Kimmy person, she has got the same sorrowness and the same secret according to her family. This is the story all about, and it's a grim story, but I'm not describing it very detailed because that is up to you readers. So, I'm an author. I'm called Jussi Adler Olsen. But that's not the whole truth. My real name is Carl Valdemar Jussi Adler Henry Olsen. And I was not Christian Jussi. No, no. I was Christian Carl Valdemar Henry Adler Olsen. And my greater sisters, my older sister said, this is a shame. And they are so right. Carl Valdemar, my God, what a family. So they said, this is Junior. And my mother said, no, 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 it won't do. And my father said, call him Jule then. And once again, it didn't make any sense. So my mother said, well, we're going to call him Jussi, because I know an opera singer from Sweden, and he sings well, and this is a nice name. So when I was 6 years old, I came into school, or just before, and my father took me aside and said, do you know what, Jussi? When they call you Carl, it's you. I was scared of that, you know. Wasn't my name really Jussi? So I sat in the corner and said, I'm not going to school at all. So we had to write the king of Denmark, called Frederick the Ninth, and we waited, you know, for the letter. And when the letter came, there stood with big, big letters, well, this guy is from now on also Jussi. So I always, you know, I always had that name. This Jussi Adler Olsen here, he tried a lot of things in his life. I have been composing music. I've studied a lot of things, even mathematics and statistics, which I love, but also movies. And movies, you know, that's the way I'm writing to you, readers. I'm cutting my books, and I'm trying not to describe it very carefully. because my readers are clever. They can describe themselves. And if I'm doing grim things, it's all happening in your heads, not in mine. I mean, if I'm telling about in Shandong that an old man is beaten by young kids, you're thinking about a weak old man. I didn't say that. You're thinking even of a weak, nice old man. I didn't write that. So this connection between you and I, the reader and me, that's the best, you know, ever happened in my life, because you are living through my books and you are making the grim deeds. You are the one who makes yourself pervert for a minute, and I'm the one who's getting rid of the whole thing by writing it to you. Ha ha. So I'm going to read a little aloud in Danish from this Shandong. It's called, ja, ich weiß nicht, was das heißt in Deutsch, aber Fasanmorderen oder sowas, ne? Jedenfalls, in Danish, you are allowed in your home to laugh now, because this is the worst language in the whole world. Endnu et skud bragede hen over trætoppene. Klappernes råb var blevet tydeligere. Pulsens dunken trykkede nu mod trommehinderne, mens den fugtige luft blev presset op så hurtigt lungerne, at det smertede. Løb, løb, ikke falde. Jeg kommer aldrig op igen, hvis jeg falder. Fuck, fuck. Hvorfor kan jeg ikke få mine hænder fri? Åh, løb. De må ikke høre mig. Har de hørt mig? Er det nu? Skal mit, virkelig, mit liv virkelig ende sådan? Og grene svirpede mod ansigtet og trak blodstriber, og blod blandede sig med sved. Let's try to hear a little sample in German. This is not my language. I'm only trying, you know. So let's hear. I'm taking another part now. This is a part, a little part about the protagonist, the main character called Kimmy. Det er en strøget i Kopenhagen centrum, hinter Unterzugehen, empfand sie wie einen Tanz auf Messerschneide. Ein echtes Risiko. Das Gesicht, halb hinter einem schlammgrünen Tuch versteckt, hastete sich an den hell erleuchteten. Oh my God, this is, you know, this is so long words you have in German. Let's take a little shorter words, right? Unter dem Bild stand, Dito Pram kauft für 12 Milliarden Kronen Privatkliniken in Polen auf. Oh, let's stop there. I guess you have the impression of me and German, that's not the right combination, right? So, next year, we're having the third novel in German, and it's called Erlösung. I mean, Erbarmen und Schändung und Erlösung. Are you coming to think of the books of Stieg Larsson in German? Yes, I think so. This is not my idea, but I'm not Stieg Larsson, you know. He died. I'm still here. So next year, number 3, and then the next 7 years after that, one big book every year, just, you know, to spoil your night's sleep a little and make you laugh in the daytime. Have a nice time, and take care out there. Bye.